Hi, I'm Peter, and in this video, I'm going to show you a green screen setup that's easy to use, cheap, and fits in a very small space. Using a green screen, or to give it its proper name, a chroma key, is very useful for video creators. However, setting up a conventional one with its extra lights, stands, and extra floor space required, and a very temperamental backdrop, is time-consuming and basically can be a real pain in the ass. However, the way I do it is with this small ring light positioned in front of the camera, green or blue light, a switch box which can switch from green to blue, and of course you can switch it off. And probably the most important ingredient, this cloth at the back here. That's the magic. It's so easy to use. I'm loving the results I'm getting out of this. No need to iron or steam the backdrop because you need it to be wrinkle free. That doesn't really matter with this cloth. There are no extra lights needed to illuminate the backdrop from the side, which cause shadows and really annoying hotspots. In fact, this is so easy to key out in your favorite editing software. It's a breeze. Gone are those bulky lights and cumbersome stands. You just save floor space right there. So let's take a closer look at how I made it. Before we look at the cloth, let's take a look at the electronic setup for the ring light. It consists of the ring light, the control unit, a cable to link the control unit to the ring light, and a 12 volt 1 amp power supply. Using the system is easy. Simply connect the cable to the control box and then the ring light. Attach the power and turn on the unit. The camera doesn't pick up this too well and the color might not be that accurate, but you get a better idea of each ring when I dial down the dimmer a little. You can toggle between green and blue with a simple switch. The ring light is made using two halo lights. These are complete units, pre-wired and sold in pairs. They're designed to pimp up your car headlights or fog lights. They're sold in a variety of diameters, and for this project I used an 11 cm, which is about 4 1/4 inches, a green one, and a smaller 8 1/2 cm, 3 1/4 inches, blue one. They also come with plastic diffusers. I made the light a few months back, but I didn't film the build. But I do have some spare parts to show what it's made from. The ring light is housed in a 13 cm, what's that, about 5 1/4 inches, plant pot saucer. I cut the middle out as the ring light is designed to fit around the lens of a DSLR. Small slots were also made to accommodate the diffusers, which have little plastic lugs on. The LED rings are held in place by the diffusers, which clip into the slots. Sorry to jump a few steps, as I say, I didn't film the build, but it was a really simple job of gluing in a lens hood that screws into our camera, fixing a small project box to accommodate the wiring to the socket, and applying a few coats of matte black spray paint. The cable connectors I used here are a 3-pin variety, which are sold as Aviation plugs. They really are a quality little product and were shipped from China for just a few pounds. They are shaped so they can only fit one way. They lock in place with a threaded retainer. They're ideal. The 3-core cable is a type as used by some car trailer wiring. I bought a couple of meters to allow me to operate the switch a distance away from the camera. The control unit consists of a PWM DC motor speed controller, but I'm using it as a dimmer. It's rated at 13 kHz, so the camera doesn't see any flickering from the LED lights. Along with the dimmer, the unit has a DC power socket, a male aviation socket, a 3-pole toggle switch, and an on-off switch, which isn't pictured because I didn't have a spare. These parts are housed in an aluminium extruded project box, which was drilled out accordingly. I was going to talk you through how it's all wired, but it really is straightforward. I guess you could pause the video and just have a look to see how everything is connected, but don't look too closely as my soldering is pretty abysmal.
The retroreflective material is, as I said at the beginning of this video, where the real magic is. I'm using this flashlight to attempt to show you how the retroreflective properties work. In essence, the light is reflected directly back at the flashlight. When I hold the flashlight next to the camera, you might be able to see, no matter how I angle the material, the light is still reflected back. Magic. If you shop around, you might discover that this is made by 3M here in the UK and is very expensive. However, I picked up a couple of meters on a roll of 1.4 meters wide for about £30 delivered. The equivalent 3M, I think, would set you back 5 or 6 times that amount, and for this application, I don't believe it would be any better. I have thought about fixing the cloth to a pop-up screen, but I've not got around to doing that, and at the moment, it's just on a roll of blind fitting.
So I hope you liked that and found it useful. I love the simplicity of it all. But tell me what you think. My next challenge is to make this system work with a teleprompter. That has its own little challenges by itself. So look out for that video in the future. Oh, and how about a name for this thing? I've called it a Chroma Key bicolour ring light thingy. Yeah, that's naff. I know. Maybe you can think of a better name. That's it for this one. Do the usual. Like, dislike, comment, share, subscribe. It's all appreciated. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.